boys and girls, Super Bowl Sunday is here. Get your poke rinds and poke rinds and pig skins. Rudolph Foods makes some of the finest you can buy, and you can actually make them at home yourself. Go to their, visit their website and look for pellets. You can buy the pellets and make them yourself if you can't find this in your area. And they're very, very good. Excellent products. Make all kind of other products too under different names. And I want to give a happy birthday shout out to Matt's son, Spencer, who's going to be 9 years old on February the 8th. I may have actually already did this, but I'm going to do it again in this Rudolph Foods Pigskin Super Bowl Sunday video. So that's what I'm cooking for Super Bowl Sunday is pigskins. Yum. So here I got some traditional poke rinds and some traditional pigskins and some pork rinds. And they're very similar, except this product has more meat on it than this one does. This is all cut from the pork belly, which is where your bacon comes from. Is that light in your eyes? Sorry about that, Cammy. And yeah, this is where your bacon comes from. And these have been processed and they're ready to just fry. And you can put seasoning on them if you want. You don't have to. I'm just gonna sprinkle them with some Cajun seasoning after they come out to fry. And I'm using a little Fry Daddy. And I took this thing and modified it so it'll fit down in there to hold those pellets down under the oil. And that's important. You don't want them to float in that oil. You want them to sit down under the oil. And we're gonna check its temperature. We're at 318, 320 coming up. We want to hit it up to about, I think, 375. And then we're gonna start putting the pellets in. So get your frying station ready. And I've got a colander, some paper towels in them to drain them. And we're gonna use this to scoop them out with as well as hold them down. And our oil is coming up to temp. We're gonna drop a few in at a time. Draw hot oil and keep them underneath the oil. They don't want to float, but you gotta keep them under the oil. And I'm just using vegetable oil. You could use lard, you could use shortening. See how they want to float, puff up. You just keep them under the oil. Get out in there, boy. Don't give me no crap. They only take about 30, 45 seconds and they're ready. Pull this batch out, put a little seasoning, do another batch. Repeat. See there? Okay. Kind of give them a little bit of drainage. Move them over here. Get another batch in. Don't put too many at a time though. Unless you got a bigger deep fryer, which I do. But I don't feel like dirtying it up. And I got a brand new Fry Daddy. So I applied a little bit of seasoning. Probably a little bit heavy on the seasoning. It's all right. It's why they call them cracklings, listen. Them crackling. Whoa, y'all get down under that Earl. Be sneaking out of there on me. put a few too many in that time, JB. Just hold them down. Push them back, way back. We get to go watch the cheerleaders and eat these cracklings on Super Bowl Sunday. Man, don't them look fine. Repeat, keep repeating. And then we move on to the ones that got more skin on them. They don't poof up quite as much, but they are sure tasty too. So after your first couple batches are done, get you a big bag and put you a paper towel down at the bottom of it. These all been seasoned. So we're gonna dump these in the bag. Set them off to the side and fry some more. Let's change this diaper here. And keep repeating. We fill that bag up. And these are Southern tradition. I mean, these date back many years. And they're excellent with beer, a soda pop. And you can put these on a hamburger, a hot dog, and it tastes like bacon, fried bacon. Are they good? Shit. Yum. Wonderful. I said, start recording, stupid camera. Okay, these are the ones with the more meat on them. Starting those. Already got a batch or two out. And they don't puff up as much as with the regular pigskins do. I think these are pork rinds. Got more meat on them, got more flavor. We'll get some more out there, crunchier also. But these are not true hard cracklings. Hard cracklings are difficult to process and deal with. So we're gonna finish these up. And we're going to season these also. And they're so wonderful. Oh, yum. Tastes like fried pig meat. Yum.